Well, a big story this morning. For the finance minister, it was a tightrope walk, but P. Chidambaram still managed a fine balancing act on budget 2013 in a crucial pre-election year. As expected, the principal opposition party wasn't too impressed and called the finance minister's picture of the Indian economy unrealistic.
Madam Speaker, I rise to present the budget for the year 2013-2014.
Finance minister standing up to deliver his 8th budget, and the nation stood and watched in anticipation. Chidambaram doing the tightrope walk of having to balance the fiscal deficit, provide for UPA's flagship schemes, and also not tax the common man. Increasing the duties of a whole range of luxury items, ranging from automobiles to electronics, jewellery, but sparing the aam aadmi any tax shocks.
Tax benefit to the first home buyer who takes a loan for an amount not exceeding rupees 25 lakhs. I propose to allow such home buyers an additional deduction of interest of rupees 1 lakh to be claimed.
But the principal opposition party not too impressed with the number jugglery carried out.
The budget is verbose, but on substance it's extremely low.
Blaming the government for the slowdown and self-inflicted wounds of ballooning fiscal deficit. The opposition accusing the government of a non-inclusive budget.
जो तीन चेहरे वित्त मंत्री ने कहा कि इस सरकार को दिखते हैं, एक महिला, एक युवा और एक गरीब, ना तो उन तीनों को कुछ दिया है।
मैंने उनको समझने में कहीं कोई गलती नहीं की। ये बजट अगर एक शब्द में कहा जाए तो बाजीगरी का बजट, ये बहुत क्लेवरली ड्राफ्टेड बजट है।
The political blame game was truly on, with the key players who have supported the UPA in the past running down UPA2's last budget.
बजट ने ऐसा कर दिया है कि किसान का पूरी तरह से उपेक्षा और चौपट, और मजदूर और गरीब का। ये बजट केवल 10% लोगों के लिए है।
यह है लॉलीपॉप इलेक्शन बजट, विथ टोकनिज्म, विथ नो सीरियस एफर्ट टू मोबिलाइज फंड्स।
विभिन्न विभागों को लेकर जो कुछ घोषणाएं की हैं, तो मैं समझती हूँ कि वो केवल हवाई हैं।
But the party was all praise for the pre-poll budget, although it lacked any major election-oriented SOPs, which may have boosted its chances in the upcoming polls.
The budget is prudent, the budget is productive, and the budget is progressive. The finance minister has done a commendable job in delivering a budget which would boost growth.
I'm happy with the budget. I don't think that any finance minister could have done better. I think he's taken care of the poor, the ordinary, and he has also taken care of providing incentives for growth.
Balancing sentiments in a pre-election year budget with constraints of a tough economic year, the FM preferring prudence over populism, while the politics over the budget begins. Bureau Report, Times Now.